the sickness, health, for all the joys, He will be always with you. And this is very important. It is also an example for other young couples to follow. Now, all the married couples who are present here, they will probably tell you that honeymoon usually ends quickly. And then they have to face the hard reality of life, which is not always easy. But what keeps them together is that unconditional love for one another, their faith. There will be times, we call it the storms of life, they will come, they always do, often unexpectedly. There will be times of temptations, but always remember this day, what you promised to each other and what you promised to God, to be always together for the rest of your lives. It is something very, very profound, and all very happy to be here with you. It also reminds other couples of their marriage, that they got married. It is also important to be always grateful to your parents. They made a lot of sacrifices for you. They are very proud of you. And always be respectful, always be gentle with your parents, always be grateful, especially to your moms. As we celebrate Mother's Day tomorrow, you will receive many advices. People will come to you and wish you this or that. I just want to ask you to come to church, be faithful to each other. Come to church on Sunday. Don't ever be embarrassed to say, yes, I am Christian, I am Catholic. Don't ever be embarrassed. And make all decisions together. In marriage, there's no place for selfishness. And you, future doctors, lawyers, like the last time I was so stressed out, some of you probably recognize me from 3 years ago. I was so stressed out. I knew all the lawyers, all the doctors from Minnesota. And here I am, a simple priest, and I was shaking. But because of Courtney and Matthew, they made it so easy and just so beautiful. But please remember, always come to church, especially on Sunday. Pray together. There are places that Catholic priests are not welcome anymore. I was told that I cannot even say church, that marriage is between a man and a woman, because it is offensive. I don't know where the world is going to, but you and me, by your lives, you will give witness to the Lord and to the world. From the very beginning, God created male and female. You cannot change that. If others have different opinions, well, we pray for them. But you will be, because of your high positions, because of your education, never be embarrassed, never be ashamed to say that, yes, I am Krishna, I am the follower of Jesus Christ. Matthew was looking at his watch. Now we're going to ask Paul. Did you? No, you're not. Don't give a lot. I was teasing, I'm sorry. But I think enough few words, enough short reflection. This is what I wanted to say, and I wish you all the best. Are we ready? Are you sure? Alright. Please come out. Strengthen your love in the presence of the Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of the Church, I ask you to state your intentions. Matthew and Annie, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept many, 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 many children lovingly from the heart according to the law of Christ and His Church? Say yes. Lord, bless and consecrate these rings. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other, and always remind them of their love for Christ our Lord. Push hard.
Yeah.
But today's been awesome. We've had the best wedding party ever. And we could all say that we probably had very little sleep, very little water, a lot of other things, but everything else but that. Paul and Kathy last night was absolutely amazing. Best friends in there. That whole part where we weren't going to have any cocktails, that Dad, Mom, can you stand up? If you want to compliment me, just talk to her. It's been great. To all the mothers out there, thank you for spending your Mother's Day with us. We got a little Brent, his birthday is today. Travis' birthday is today. So yeah. We appreciate everyone. You mothers are all great. You. And everything, it's just really, I appreciate it. I want everybody to have a good time though. I want to crank it up a little bit. I have a whole lot of fun, and I'm sure my dad's not going to say it well.
Very quick. I just have to first thank Dave, Sharon, and my parents. I would actually like to propose a toast to these guys because they've put on a hell of a show. So cheers. Let's get this damn party started.